This is Industry Wednesday. Every Wednesday, we analyze a different industry. Today, we're looking at 15 things you didn't know about the textile industry. Welcome to alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get informed. Hello, Aluxers, and welcome back to our channel. How's life been treating you these days? Silky and smooth like a piece of cashmere clothing? We hope it does, since today we're talking about the controversies and insights of the textile industry. Clothing, garments, fabrics, leather, they're all produced in factories. Both natural and synthetic fabrics are being shaped and altered long before ending up on our shelves. Even if we all love a nice and expensive piece of clothing, the textile and fashion industry often do a lot of wreckage. The textile industry is huge and extremely important, as we're sure you can imagine. It's an industry that helped countries like India grow a lot economically, and it's now worth billions of dollars. If you're new here, welcome. Be sure to subscribe and follow us on Instagram at Alux. But without further ado, we have the pleasure to present to you today the 15 things you didn't know about the textile industry. Number 1. Cotton is the world's most important natural fiber. Take a piece of clothing from your closet and check the label. What does it say? Among other information about the size and how to preserve it, it's also saying what it's made of. Clothing, towels, napkins, curtains, pillows, and others are usually made out of two kinds of fibers, natural or synthetic. Cotton is one of the most important and used natural fibers. Cotton is a soft, fluffy staple fiber that grows in a ball or protective casing around the seeds of the cotton plant. The fiber is almost pure cellulose and has a white color. This fiber has been used very much in the textile industry because it's very soft, durable, and sensitive to the skin. Number 2. Vegan and ethical choices are the newest trends in the industry. Trends dictate what is good, what is bad, what's staying, and what will never make it every season. They usually change every 6 months and have a huge impact on the textile industry. Fast fashion is such a huge thing that people usually keep an item of clothing only for a season and then throw it away. In perspective, this is not doing anything good for the planet, since making all of these clothes means polluting the environment. That's why a handful of companies decided to invest in vegan and ethical trading fibers that helps the environment and offers a safer and cleaner alternative. It's very important to keep all of the supply chain involved in the process, so the final product can be vegan or considered ethical. Number 3. Bangladesh has the cheapest workforce for the textile industry. Bangladesh, among other Western regions, is still a developing country. They are struggling with respect to human rights and fighting the minimum wage. Since the population is so poor, they're willing to work for as little as a few dollars per day. And big retailers like Zara or H&M are opening factories there. Buying cheap materials and having cheap employees are the key factors to keeping the prices relatively low and meet the demands of the market of fast fashion. In Bangladesh, working in the textile industry is pretty much the only job there is, which doesn't give much power to the people to get paid any better. Number 4. Clothes and textiles must follow national and international standards. Even though the clothes we see so beautifully folded in malls are made in dusty and polluted factories, and they still need to follow some standards in order to make it to the shelf. These standards ensure that quality, sustainability, and safety are met throughout the process, and clothes are sold at their right value. The sad part is that these rules and regulations don't also apply to the factories the clothes are manufactured in. Number 5. The textile industry is now worth almost $3 trillion. So far, no billionaire and industry has come close to this figure. Since textiles are used so widely, it's no wonder that this industry is one of the most prosperous in the world, along with the food and petrol industries. Today's global clothing and textile industry is worth approximately $3 trillion and produces 80 billion garments worldwide every year, employing about 75 million people worldwide. In this industry, Nike is among the biggest clothing exporter, second in the world, with revenues of over $30 billion per year. Number 6. the textile industry is the second biggest polluting industry after oil. The journey of a natural or synthetic fiber is a long one and paved with chemical processes. From the raw material to dresses and shoes is a long journey most people don't care to know. Fibers have to be dyed, stretched, pressed, treated with all sorts of chemicals, and sometimes glued or sprayed to have a certain look, texture, or shape. All these chemicals are polluting, and it all ends up in rivers and in the air. Not to mention, once again, how toxic the environment is for all of the employees. To this point, only the oil industry is polluting more than the textile industry, and that's because we're all so dependent on both. Number 7. In the UK, the textile companies don't pay minimum wage either. We've talked about Bangladesh and how their workers are treated in factories. It's the same in Morocco or India. Low wages and long working shifts. You would expect countries like the UK to be different, but it's not. Famous retailers like River Island, New Look, or Misguided often hire other companies to take care of the factories and the whole manufacturing process. These companies end up paying the workers half of the minimum wage required in the UK, which is almost $11 per hour. Number 8. India's textile market is expected to reach $226 billion market cap by 2023. India is one of the world's biggest textile producers, being number 2 behind China's textile industry, representing more than 4% of the country's total GDP and more than 14% of its yearly exports. The industry hires around 105 million people directly and indirectly, and it's set to reach $226 billion by the year 2023. The big advantage India holds is the ease of producing a wide range of fibers, from natural to synthetic ones like polyester or nylon. Oh, and guess what? India is also the biggest cotton producer in the world, reaching roughly 6 million kilograms in 2017. Number 9. The US is the world's biggest importer of garments in the world. And who do they import from? Yep, from China. Up to 50% of all apparel products sold in the US come from China and the rest from other developing countries that provide cheap workforce, like Bangladesh or India. Actually, the textile manufacturing industry in the US has declined by more than 80% over the past two decades, and they're only justifying it because there's way cheaper labor out there. The US is one of the biggest fashion consumers in the world, with the average American spending roughly up to $1,700 a year on clothing, with women aged between 45 and 54 spending an average of $793 per year on clothing alone. Number 10. The most expensive fabric in the world is the vicuña wool. Cotton is one of the most used fabrics in the world. Leather, fur, cashmere, and synthetic fibers are also widely used, and often very expensive. Of course, one of the most expensive fabrics in the world is fur, especially furs that come from exotic animals. But what's the most expensive fabric in the world, you ask? Wool. The wool from the vicuña goat comes from the high altitudes of the Andes in South America. Bolivia, Chile, Argentina, and Peru. And it's the most expensive because it's extremely rare and difficult to obtain, as vicuña sheep can only be shorn every 3 years. The cost of the fabric ranges from $1,800 to $3,000 per yard. Another thing that makes vicuña wool so expensive is the fact that the animal starves itself in captivity, which means farming it is almost impossible. Want to find out some more about expensive fabrics and other fashionable facts? Make sure you also watch our 15 Things You Didn't Know About the Fashion Industry video. Number 11. Fabric art is a popular thing. The most amazing thing about art is the fact that one can create it out of anything. All it needs is a creative mind and some inspiration. Well, that being said, it should come as no surprise that artists use fabric to create rugs, paintings, and sculptures, or to make statements about the consumerist world that we live in. You can find some in museums, and the Royal School of Needlework in England offers fiber arts classes. This is not a new art, however. People have been using fabrics to create art since forever, putting together impressive rugs or blankets or tapestries that have been sold for good money to royal or rich families. Number 12. Textile piracy is causing significant losses in the industry. The issue is extremely harmful to the textile industry, with fiber counterfeits entering the markets from China, especially at significantly lower prices. This not only hurts local economies, but can also put humans' health at risk because all of the chemicals used in order to produce the fabrics. Ghana is one of the countries that face this problem, losing about $150 million every year because of textile piracy and smuggling. The issue was addressed by M. Pedigree, a local technology company that created a digitized system that identifies if a product is original or not, but there's still a long way to go in the fight against counterfeit products. Number 13. Technology in textiles is the future in this industry. And it is in every industry known to humans so far. Slowly but surely, everything became manufactured in factories, by machines and computers. We've come a long way over the past 100 years, and nobody plans on stopping. The textile industry has also developed. You can now find all sorts of fibers and fabrics designed for specific activities and types of body. Sports, dancing, running, climbing, swimming, festival costumes, and so on are now specially designed and more reliable than ever. Just take a look at crowdfunding websites if you want to see what people develop in this industry. Number 14. China is the world's largest textile producer. There's always one country that provides the whole world with all sorts of things, whether it's food, clothing, electronic components, or natural resources. In the textile industry, China is the world leader, exporting all over the world tons of different textiles. India comes in a close second place for both production and exports. The largest Chinese companies that go into the textile industry are owned by the state, so their success helps the economy to grow significantly. Taking into consideration that China is also a big manufacturing country with cheap labor, it's no wonder the country has one of the biggest economies in the world. Number 15. The USA is responsible for 15 million tons of used textile waste each year. Studies show an average American throws away approximately 80 pounds of used clothing every year, and it costs cities an average of $45 per ton to dispose of old clothing. Textile waste can take up to hundreds of years to decompose, and a more environmentally friendly way to dispose of them is donating to charity. Brands like H&M have also started anti-waste campaigns, asking people to give them all of their unwanted clothes in order to recycle them. Which is great, we need more people doing that. And Aluxers, that's it for today's video. We took a dive into this industry to offer you some insights and details about it. Now before you go, as always, we're curious. What's the most expensive piece of clothing you own? Let us know in the comments. And for sticking with us until the end and being a true Aluxer, here's your bonus fact. Number 16. 70% of donated clothes end up being sold in East African countries. People can donate these basic products and help developing countries or others in need. What most of us don't know is that donated clothing ends up being sold to shops in East African countries like Kenya, Uganda, or Ethiopia. When most people in Uganda go shopping, it's usually for something that somebody else wore first. 70% of the clothing donated around the world eventually makes its way to Africa's clothing markets. So, like they say, no good deed goes unpunished. Thank you for spending some time with us, Aluxers. Make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpicked these videos, which we recommend you watch next. Thank you for being an Aluxer, and we'll see you back tomorrow.